Hello friends, welcome to MechaBit Forum. Today we are going to discuss about the crank effort diagram. It is also known as a turning movement diagram. And today, this diagram is for a single cylinder double acting engine that is also known as a two stroke engine. So before proceeding, we should know that what is a crank effort diagram? It is a diagram that is drawn between two axes, X and Y, that is the between crank angle and the turning movement. So this diagram basically tells us about the development of a torque at different positions of the crank. The importance of getting this knowledge is that we should know that how much amount of torque an engine can develop at its different position so that we can design and place the engine accordingly into the required vehicle. This diagram also helps us to improvise the design and further achieve the best design to develop maximum torque at different positions of the crank. So let's start the video. Here in this diagram, you can see that we are having the x-axis to which crank angle is denoted, and on the y-axis we have the turning moment denoted. On the crank angle, we have the different positions of the crank, that is 0 degree, 90 degree, 180, 270 and 360. And correspondingly to the turning moment, we have three positions, that is T minimum, T mean and T max. So this T minimum is the minimum torque developed by the engine. This is T mean to this axis, that is the mean resisting torque developed by the engine, mean torque, that is the average torque. And here it is T max, that is the maximum torque developed by the engine. Obviously, the maximum torque developed by the engine is at point B and D to this curve ABC and curve CDE. This curve ABC is known as the outstroke curve, and curve CDE is known as the instroke curve. So to understand what is the outstroke curve and instroke curve, you have to just see onto your left hand side. There I have drawn a rough piston cylinder, crankshaft and connecting rod assembly. Here you could see that here it is a crankshaft, then connecting rod to this piston is connected, similarly to all the diagrams. And you could see that piston is to its topmost position, that is the top dead center. Top dead center is a point beyond which the piston cannot move further. And here you could see that we are having the bottom dead center. This bottom dead center is the bottommost position of the crank, again beyond which the piston cannot move further. So you could see that at particular this point, the crank angle is zero. How the crank angle is zero? Because the crankshaft is not making any angle. It is just flattened, to which the connecting rod is flattened and the piston is at its top dead center. So the angle is zero. So when the piston is moving outwards, that is away from the cylinder head, this is known as the outstroke. So here the piston is taking the outstroke and finally reaches to the bottom dead center. So the curve ABC up to point 180 degree is this outstroke. And further, when it starts moving towards the cylinder head, that is known as the instroke position. So here you could see that the piston is moving 270 degree. That is, it has start taking the instroke and the piston is moving towards the top dead center. So finally, it reaches to 360 degree and this is known as the instroke position of the crank. Coming back to this diagram, here you could see that at point A, the torque is zero. This torque is zero because here you can see that crank is making no movement. So as the crank is making no movement, there is no crank angle and hence the torque is zero at this point A. As the piston starts moving, so it will make the crank to turn. As the crankshaft rotates to 90 degree, here you could see that crankshaft, as it is moving away from the cylinder head, that is, it is making the outstroke, it reaches to the middle of the position to 90 degree. And here you could see that the piston is working on the gas. So as the piston is working on the gas, we are having the maximum torque developed at this point B. Further, as it reaches to point C, that is 180 degree, the piston reaches to bottom dead center. And again, here the crankshaft is in alignment with the connecting rod. So as again, the crank angle is flattened to 180 degree, the torque is again zero. Further, as the piston starts taking the inward stroke, it moves to the middle of the position and again makes a 90 degree addition turn, that is 270 degree, and here the torque developed by the engine is again maximum. Here you can see at point D, and further as it moves to point E, that is 360 degree, again the crankshaft comes to the original position from where it was started earlier, and again it becomes flattened, aligned with the connecting rod, and here the torque developed again is zero. Work done by the engine is turning moment into crank angle. So the turning moment diagram ABC for the out stroke and CDE for the in stroke represents the work done per revolutions. So basically these two curves shows the work done by the piston. And here you could see T mean line. This T mean line is the mean resisting torque line. And in actual practice, it is believed that the engine that develops the work is above the mean torque line. And below the mean torque line, the rest of the work that is developed by the engine is used to overcome all the resistances that are produced by the moving parts. So basically, what we are getting the work is only and only above the mean resisting torque line. So here we can draw the inference that this area of the curve is the main work done by the engine to generate the power, whereas the area below this mean torque line is the work done by the piston over the gases. In the simple language, we can understand that the area above the mean resisting torque line is the energy produced by the engine, and the area below the mean resisting torque line is the energy given by the engine over the gases to extract the work from it. Above the mean resisting torque line, you can see there are two positive curves, that is capital B small b C and capital D small d E. These two positive curves above the mean line shows that the crankshaft is accelerating. It is getting some energy from the gases. And the curves below the mean resisting torque line, that are capital A small a B small C capital D capital C, this curve indicates that the piston and the crankshaft is retarding, means the gases are achieving the work from this piston. In this way, the work done by a two-stroke engine is clearly visible to us from the outstroke and the instroke. And the torque developed by the engine to the different positions of the crank that draw an effort to propel the engine. So this was a precise explanation of a turning moment diagram for a single cylinder double acting engine, that is two stroke engine, and a crank effort diagram. So if you like the description, please do like the video and subscribe the channel for more similar updates. Thank you and bye bye.